me start with the basic premise that boys and girls, teenagers, adolescents will get attracted to each other. There's nothing wrong with it, there's nothing to be to question it. It is something that comes from within. It is a hormonal activity. When your hormones get activated, there is a very natural sexual urge. There is an attraction to the opposite gender. That has existed since time immemorial. Today, what we are a little, you know, what we need to become aware of is the fact that technology has made matters much easier than what it used to be. The whole concept of how boys and girls interact has become different. Earlier, a boy had to go onto the road, stand in front of a girl's school, or try to throw a paper plane or something of that sort. And that is how they used to try and mix. And whenever they tried that, there was always this policing of parents, teachers, whoever it is, and they used to get things under control, supposedly. Today, children, due to technology, teenagers particularly, have such easy access to anybody across the gender that that basic thrill of whatever, you know, interacting with a person of the opposite gender, which used to be a conquest type of thing, that is gone. So, in fact, many of us adults are not aware that teenagers today have come to that state of mind where we say, no, been there, done that type of thing. So what's so great about talking to a girl, what's so great about dating, what's so great about this or that or anything of that sort. Whereas many of us adults still continue to live in the past and we think that if I've got a teenage girl at home or if I'm a teacher, I should become protective towards that person. And because of technology, the physical protection has absolutely lost its meaning. You cannot protect. There are children who at midnight will be chatting up with each other. You have video calls, you can see each other, you can do just about anything that you want. You can meet up in anonymity in different places. Social media has given you so much opportunity. So what I want us to understand is that let us not panic when we see boys and girls intermingling freely, which is what we used to do. Because we used to think that if a teenager is let loose without supervision, they may not know where to draw the line and they may cross the limit. My experience has been that teenagers of today not only understand their limits, they are not bothered about the limit. They know that they can cross the limit, but they don't want to do it. So it's like, you never get ice cream or chocolate, and obviously the day you get it, you would love to jump on it. But if you are, staying in an ice cream factory or something of that sort, obviously you're not going to eat ice cream for morning goes. And then at the time will come and you will say that, okay, enough is enough, and then I want, I'll take a little bit, otherwise I'm not going to cross any limits or anything of that sort. That is what I want you to understand as the basic thing. The other thing most important is that while communication has significantly improved, means of communication has improved because of technology, the actual emotional communication between adults and teenagers is getting fizzled out. So any teenager whom you are concerned about, whether it's regarding boy-girl relationship, whether it's regarding anything, please be aware of what is your communication. If your communication is good, if the teenager can come and talk to you about anything under the sun, then you just don't have to worry. Nothing will happen with which we are normally scared of, or that they will do something which is unwanted. The other thing is that these teenagers are going to grow up into a world where there is going to be free mixing of the sexes. People are working 24/7. People are traveling from one country to another, a man and a woman or whatever it is. They have teams of people, they go out of parties, they have conferences and meetings in any part of the world and things of that sort. Now, if a boy or a girl does not know during teenage, has not had the privilege of mixing with the opposite gender, he or she may, find it like that forbidden fruit and may want to do things in early adulthood, which may be not really good. So keeping this in mind, I would say that the bottom line of ensuring good healthy boy-girl relationship is that you maintain very good communication, allow the teenagers to talk to you on any topic. Nothing should be taboo, nothing should be criticized or anything of that sort. And stop panicking. Whatever the child comes and tells, whatever is happening between a boy and a girl, if we do not panic, you will realize that we are able to handle it much better. Okay.